It was night time, around 9 o'clock. Gattu and Chinky were watching cartoon sitting in front of the TV. And Dad was checking his office file sitting there along with them. Mom was working in the kitchen. After cleaning the utensils and the kitchen and finishing all the household chores, Mom came to the hall.
What is this? You guys are still awake? Gattu, Chinky, turn off the TV and go to your room. It's almost midnight.
Mom, please, tomorrow is a Sunday. Let us watch the cartoon.
But son...
Mom, please, don't disturb. Do we disturb you in between your cereals?
Mom got angry after hearing Chinky's words and she turned her eyes towards Dad.
Hey, how long you're gonna take with these files? Don't you have to sleep? Every day you go to bed right after having dinner. What happened today?
Please, don't disturb, man. So many files are pending. Every second is precious to me.
Saying this, Papa again got busy with his files and Mom kept watching everyone in turn.
Kids want to watch cartoon. He's busy with his office work. And no one wants to spend time with me. Never mind. I will go to bedroom and sleep.
Saying this, Mom left for the bedroom. As soon as Mom left, Dad slammed the file.
After seeing the file, I would have slept before Mom.
Chinky yawned and said,
No sleeping, Dad. No sleeping, Gattu.
When Chinky looked at Gattu, Gattu was already asleep.
Get up, Gattu. Get up, son. Oh, he's not even moving.
Get up, Gattu. Gattu. It's 12 o'clock, Gattu.
Hearing this, Gattu hurriedly got up and sat down.
12 o'clock? Let's go. Where's the cake?
Seeing Gattu's condition, Dad smiled and said,
Gattu, it is not yet 12 o'clock and the cake has not arrived yet. You go and see whether Mom is sleeping or not.
When Gattu left, Dad shouted from behind.
And listen, come back just seeing. Don't fall asleep over there.
Gattu went and came back after a while and said,
Mom is sleeping. Yes.
Where is this delivery boy?
Dad, do one thing. Open the door. And why so? If the delivery boy will come and ring the doorbell, Mom could wake up from that and that will spoil our surprise.
Chinky is absolutely right. Let me open the door.
Saying this, Dad went to the door and as soon as he opened the door, the delivery boy was standing in front with the box of the cake.
What a perfect timing, sir. I was just about to ring the bell. Here is your cake.
Dad took the cake and paid. Then Chinky came with some money in hand and gave it to the delivery boy.
Sorry, we are not allowed to take service tips.
This tip is not for your service. It's because you did not ring the doorbell. That's why, please take it.
The boy took the tip and left.
Keep the cake in the fridge and do all the preparations.
Chinky kept the cake in the fridge and she, along with Gattu, started preparing the candles and other birthday items.